This week from the Weird World of Blobs, an adventure in art. The Weird World of Blobs is brought to you by this possessed toaster. And now your host, Nick.
Today we're going to learn about 3D printing.
Glow!
What was that?
The word of the day is glow.
Ah, the word of the day is glow. So maybe if we're 3D printing and we want it to glow, we can try to make a lamp. The first step to making a 3D printed blob lamp is to 3D model it. I'll be using the software Blender, which is free. I want the lamp to look kind of bubbly, so I'm going to start with just basic spheres and then connect them together and model the additional features. Because I want the lamp to be bright, I'm going to use translucent filament when I 3D print it. And I was thinking it might be a good idea to use vase mode, which is where the filament spirals around upwards to make one complete object. So I'm going to do a small scale test to see if this is possible. Bamboo Labs has graciously sent me their A1 printer and automated material system. And this is what we'll use to do our 3D printing today. What I love about this machine is that it is super easy to set up and just get started with. It also prints really fast. This test print only took 20 minutes. Bamboo Labs also has their own slicing software, which lets you prepare the 3D model for printing. This is where you can customize print styles, speeds, and colors. If you don't know how to 3D model, but you still want to get into 3D printing, you can use Bamboo Labs' phone app called Bamboo Handy. It has free models that you can print, and you can control and monitor your printer from the app. Here is my completed small-scale test. It turned out pretty well. You can see the top missed a few little holes, but I think when it's bigger, hopefully it will work out better. But you can see it has a really nice translucency, and it's super light, and because it's vase mode, it prints very, very fast. Oh no, our first real print didn't print correctly.
Hot damn.
But that's okay. When you're making art, you have to test out a lot of different things and see what works. It looks like vase mode isn't going to work for us because the curves of the model are a little too steep for the filaments to stick together without having additional support. So we'll try a different printing method. This time I'm trying the print with the standard settings, 5% infill with a honeycomb pattern. Okay, let's try the print again. Here is the final print off of the print bed. So I still need to clean up some of this support material before I can assemble everything. It's super easy to just peel off the supports. I also have the other piece of the lamp, which I modeled to fit directly into the body. So here are the gums and teeth, which are pretty classic for the blobs that I make. It's a two-color print of white and pink. And here are the eyeballs. They're also multicolor prints with black for the pupil and white for the rest of the eyeball. These will fit directly into the blob lamp's body. And finally, here is a translucent 3D printed blob lamp. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to go out and make something weird.
Goodbye.